Hello and welcome to Mock Productions. You are here with me, Matthew, and we are back here with a very, very exciting unboxing right here. Now, this is a box, and inside of this, I've been thinking about doing this for probably about the past 2 or 3 months. At least a good amount over November, through the whole of December, and then I finally did it in January, and it's finally arrived right here. So, what this is something that I have obviously been thinking about for those 3 years. 3 years? Hold on, calm down. 3 months. And I just thought, you know what, it's about time, we need to do it. Everything is ready and prepared, and you're about to see what all this will be for. Now, if I bring in this box right here. Now, some people, if you're, you know, regular viewers to the channel, you'll automatically know I recognise that size box. I recognise what this could possibly be. And let me just tell you, yes, it is. As you can probably see by the title as well, you're guessing very, very well. So, I'm very excited because this is our third one that we have custom made. Any hints? I'm hoping people are knowing. Here we go. I can't wait to see this, guys, because I think this is probably going to be one of the best ones that I've made so far. I'm very, very happy with what I've created here. So, without further ado, let's not ruin the whole thing. Let's get this out. So you're already probably thinking, well, yes it is. It is a playmat. Now before I ruin the whole thing, let me get this thing out of the packaging without ruining everything. Let's just, because I really want a really nice reveal for this whole mat. So let me just take out the wrapping. And it hasn't been that long since we've opened another one of these, actually. We opened one on Christmas Eve. So it's only about a two or three week period now where we've actually ordered another one. Get out of the way. All right, guys. There it is. I told you it looked really cool. It's a black playmat. There you go. So I hope you enjoyed, and I'll see you next time. No, I'm only joking. Of course I'm only joking. Let's reverse the camera up here for the reveal of what this map will be. Are we ready, guys? Because this is going to be something very, very cool indeed. Actually, just so we can get the full experience, I'm going to turn it the opposite way so I can flip it over. And it's a lot. Oh, that's a spoiler and a half right there. Are we ready, guys? In three, in two, in one. Yes! Oh my gosh. That looks crazy. Absolutely crazy. Guys, I'm going to have to do this. Sorry. I'm going to have to go hands-free. Look at that. Look at that playmat. Oh my gosh, I am so, so happy with what I've created there. It looks great. I love it. It looks so, so cool. Such an awesome looking playmat there. Very custom. Obviously, I've just taken pictures of all the Pokemon and stuck them together. Now, the whole deck that I've created is, obviously, you can see, those are all the Pokemon which go into this deck. Quite simply, and all of them are GXs. We've got GX, 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 and GX up there. And of course, Mallow is in the middle because obviously Bouncesweet was the signature Pokemon for Mallow. So to have a Tsareena GX, you've got to have Bouncesweet and Mallow. And of course, Mallow works very well with Zoroark GX. So that is the playmat right there. Now let me just show you because I've already started putting all the cards together for this deck. And I am literally, I'm so excited to be, oh, it looks so good. It looks absolutely amazing, guys. I'm happy with it. I think it looks pretty cool. It's not like, you know, the best mat ever, but it's pretty decent. I mean, you've got the trees in the background, you've got some nice grass effect here, nice ground there, the sky there with clouds going over there, the Lele flying in the sky. You've got the Zoroark right there with Zorua. Mallow, Bouncesweet, Stenee, Tsareena, and of course over there you have Pheramosa right over there, which is one of the Ultra Beasts. Now I've been doing some collecting, and you're probably going to see a lot of these openings coming up very soon, but I've managed to secure three full art Mallows, which you can't really see, but three full art Mallows, three Pheramosa GX, and three right there Tsareena, and we've also recently just opened our fourth one, which I'll just grab out now. There it is. There it is right there. So we have the four Tsareena, we have three Pheramosa GX, and three at the moment, possibly going to be four Mallow. I'm very, very excited for this deck. Of course, we do also have other cards in the deck, which I do have on the side here. You've got your Stenees, your Bouncesweets, got some rare candies, got a double colourless, and a ton of grass energy. But I like this deck. I think it could be very interesting because both of these do a bit of confusion, and confusion can be an absolute pain. Let me just show you. We'll go through it in detail here. So Pheramosa GX, now this thing comes out in a Ultra Beast collection box, which we haven't opened just yet on the channel, but I thought I have to try and get at least three of them, and three is what I've got. So first move here is Fast Raid. So that does 30 damage. It says if you go first, you can use this attack on your first turn. Now that's pretty cool because what could you take out, for example? What's weak to grass? Anything water-based, mostly, like a Lapras GX. I'm not saying you're going to knock it out, but say you can get one energy on this and a choice band. It goes up against a Lapras. I'm just saying it's a Lapras, and boom. Very, very cool. It's got a retreat of just one, and for just attaching two grass, that is pretty decent. I'm very, very happy with this. It is a basic as well, so having a max elixir is going to be very useful if this is on the bench. Cruel Spike there for 60 damage. Your opponent's active Pokemon is now confused. Now, of course, they could just Guzma out of the confusion, but it can be very annoying. If you don't have a Guzma in hand, then you're pretty much stuck. Beauty GX is a very good late game attack here. 50 times damage for each prize card your opponent has taken. If they've taken 4, you're doing 200 damage. Add a choice band, 230. It's a very, very good card. I really do like it, and hopefully I can pull it off. Hopefully. I mean, hopefully with this mat as well. It's gotta be worth something. Now, it works very well with Tsareena. Now, I'll tell you why. We've got Side-Eye here. Switch one of your opponent's bench Pokemon with their active Pokemon. The new active Pokemon is now confused. That's pretty cool. Now, of course, again, they can just go out of the confusion with a Guzma. They can just retreat out of confusion if they have enough energies. But you are switching up one of their bench Pokemon. Now, say, for example, you bring up a bench Pokemon which maybe has three retreat. Not three, three. Then at least then they've got to try and... they can either Guzma out of it, of course, or they have to try and attach before you can get the jumping sidekick in, which is if your opponent's active Pokemon is confused, this attack does 90 more damage. So you can do 180 at a choice band, you're doing 210. You're knocking out a Zoroark. That's pretty cool. A lot of people play Zoroarks now, so that's pretty cool. Queen's Command GX. This is an interesting one, although the difference between energies here is a little bit annoying. It really is. I almost want to sort of either put two grass and a colourless on it, just so you can guarantee to do that. So you're still doing three energy attachments, but instead of doing grass, you can do grass, double colourless, so you can at least do this one as well. But it's not mad. Your opponent discards four cards from their hand. So, I mean, if they're left with four cards, you're pretty much suckering them there, because they'd have to either draw into a Sycamore, maybe an N, but if they're low on prize cards, that's going to be pretty terrible. So, yeah, it's going to be interesting. It's going to be very, very interesting, and I'm super, super happy to have... I've got four Mallows. I've only got three here. I've got one in my binder. You have to have four full art Mallows, especially with a mat like this. This plays very well with Zoroark, at least I think so. With being able to search your deck for two cards, place them on the top, and then use Zoroark and trade away something, at least you can guarantee you're going to get two cards you want. That's pretty cool. You could be wanting maybe a Guzma and an energy. Boom, you can get that with this, and then obviously you can do the Zoroark as long as you've got another card in hand. So yeah, it's going to be very, very interesting indeed to see how this plays. But the mat itself, I am so, so happy with. It looks great. It really does look so, so cool. I can't wait to see what other people think of the mat. And I won't be playing it until there's actually a League Cup coming up very soon. Just one day before the pre-release. So I'm going to be using this deck there. See how it goes. But no matter what happens, I am still sticking with the Pokemon that I have here. Tsareena, Pheramosa, Tapu Lele, of course, has to be in. Everyone runs a Tapu Lele to get that Bridget. And then obviously we do have the Zoroark GX. They're not here because they're in another deck at the moment, so I can't exactly put them up here. But it's going to be very, very interesting to see how it all plays out. I'm just so, so happy with how that mat has turned out. It looks really, really good. Really, really nice indeed. I'm thinking of making maybe one more mat at this moment, but I need to know that one card is coming out. There's a card that I really, really like. We actually talked about it in one of our Ultra Prism news updates. I want to try and run that with something, and I want to try and make a deck using that card, but then have a mat to sort of go with it as well. I like to sort of make a deck and then have a mat to go with it rather than just running it with a deck, and it's like, well, hold on, you're running a grass deck with a dark playmat. What are you doing? So it's that sort of thing. But this mat is gonna, I think this is gonna be pretty interesting. It's not a lot of energy going onto Pheramosa, which is pretty cool. You can get some confusion on, a little bit of damage done as well, and then maybe finish it off with a Tsareena, which is pretty cool. The Zoroark as well, of course. If you can get 5 things on your bench, you're doing 120, and a choice band 150. So you start with this, they do a bit of damage, maybe you set a Guzma for that, boom, you're doing another 150. That's gonna be a knockout, 60 plus, yeah, pretty much. If there's a choice band on this and a Zoroark, you're probably definitely going to be doing a knockout there, unless they've got resistance. But yeah, I am super, super happy with what I've created here, and I cannot wait to see how the deck runs. I might do a bit of an update video just to let you guys know how it is going. There is also another deck which we have already seen for New Year's, which will focus very much around one card in particular from Ultra Prism. It is a water Pokemon. It is a GX. I'm guessing you know which one it is. I think that's going to be a very playable card. A lot of people are going to try and do that to stop abilities. Glaceon GX is the card I am on about, obviously, if you haven't already guessed. But I am very happy with what we've got here. Let me know your thoughts on this mat here. Do you think it's the best one out of the three? Of course, the first one was the two Lycanrocs, which I still run that deck. Very, very cool. Run it with Zoroark. That's very cool. Then, of course, the second one we made was the Totodile, Gyarados, Lapras, and Glaceon mat, which we've got, so that's pretty cool. And now we have this one, so I'm super happy with what we've created so far. Very, very interesting mats here, and they're going to be very, very cool indeed. But apart from that, I'm going to leave it here, and I will see you guys in the next video on the channel.